Well, James, we've named the squad for the West Indies Tour and the World T20 and some new faces. Let's start with Moeen Ali. Why was he selected?
Yeah, Moeen's been performing very well for Worcestershire over a number of years now, and in particularly over the last couple of years. He's been involved in our performance programmes for the same length of time. And he brings variety, he brings confidence as options for the top of the order. He also has the off-spin variety. And he is a man of immense good character, and we're looking forward to him being involved in a positive way into our squad. And congratulations to him.
You must have seen him play last year, PCA Player of the Year. He had a great season.
Yes, he has. He's got talent all around the wicket from a batting point of view. We're just looking forward to seeing his talents on the international stage as opposed just to at New Road.
What about Stephen Parry from Lancashire? What can you say about him?
Yeah, Stephen's also a man of good character. He's a team man. He gives us left arm spin option. Good reports from Lancashire. I've seen him several times. He's got a variety in his left arm spin. But more than anything else, he gives us gregariousness. He's a savvy bowler. And again, it's an exciting option. And he's going to enjoy his involvement in international cricket.
There's a third new face in this squad selection, and that's Harry Gurney, who will be going to the West Indies.
Yeah, he's got control of the white ball. He's a left-arm seamer. He gives us variety in that that area, which, of course, we are short of. So well done to Harry, and well done to Nottinghamshire, who've helped him develop. And we look forward to him again being involved in the squad and a positive influence around the group.
There's one squad effectively for two tours. What was the thinking behind that?
Well, yeah, we've got to nominate the ICC World 2020 competition in the next week. So it's going to be the same squad that goes to the West Indies. But we thought we'd have cover. And by naming 16 players for the West Indies, it gives us that. So effectively, we're going to play 2020 cricket in the West Indies. And although we've got some ODIs to play, we're using the same group. So it'll give them a chance to develop as a team together and develop their skills over in the West Indies.
I suppose also a good opportunity for those T20 players to push a place in the 50-over squad too.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we're not far away in both forms of the game. It can change very quickly. We played reasonably well in Australia in the ODIs, although a couple of games went against us. And 2020 cricket can turn around very quickly. So we've got lots of grounds for optimism. There's a lot of positivity about the squad. Owen Morgan comes in to be official vice-captain, which we're thrilled about. And we look forward to Stuart and Owen forming a good leadership team there. And, of course, led very well by Ashley Giles.
You mentioned some of those players and grounds for optimism looking ahead to the World T20. Obviously not great results in Australia, but with the likes of, you know, Hales and Wright, you know, we've got some really, really explosive players.
Yes, you know, there's fine margins in 2020, but we've got a good mixture of youth and experience in that squad, and that's a good blend. I think that'll bring excitement to the squad. And we're just looking for some real energy created, and I think the group that's assembled will be able to produce that.
One player who didn't make it into the squads is Kevin Peterson, and that must have been a tough choice earlier this week.
Yeah, correct, it was, because Kevin's been a fantastic player for England, but we recognise now is the time to rebuild, re-energise the team, and go forward with a group of individuals that we believe can bring us success. But again, Kevin's been fantastic for England, and we wish him all the best in the future.
You and your new role as national selector, have you found things so far?
Yeah, it's been an interesting time, but very challenging, and I'm enjoying it immensely. And I look forward to working with whoever comes on board on the panel in the near future, and whoever will be the England coach in the near future as well.